live special, one week only, limited edition special guest co-host Mick Mulvaney are thrilled to bring in Fox Nation host and columnist Tammy Bruce. Now, Tammy, thanks for coming here on the show tonight. We played a clip before of Joe Biden looking for a deceased congresswoman, but I want to play a couple of little more grabs. Here he was in that same speech making, well, you tell me if this makes any sense to you.
You heard from Senator, for Secretary Vilsack. Senator, excuse me, I voted you. All kidding aside, he's doing a hell of a job.
And then here he was at FEMA headquarters, or as Joe Biden would say, they're FEMA something, he was talking about Hurricane Ian.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Mr. President.
Joe Biden there with another case of the wanders. Tammy, I think we have to face this head on. Is the president still compos mentis?
Well, first of all, I thought I was your favorite American guest, but I'll give that up to Mick for a little while. It's great to be here. Nice to see you guys. Look, here's our issue, is that while this is embarrassing for Americans, it's dangerous for the world. Because we're not the only ones seeing this. And while we're looking at it, being concerned about what it means, people, the bad actors around the world, whether it be China or Russia or Iran, North Korea, realize that America does not have a president who is functional in important ways. Now, they may think, you know, that this is good for them. They're acting as though it's good for them. What we do know is that leadership requires a center of gravity. And considering the decisions that have been made, clearly the economy is in shambles. National security issues, of course, are in serious trouble. The border is wide open. So it's not just guesswork. They see a man who is not in charge of his own approach, of his own mind, perhaps. And then they see the condition of the United States and the condition of the world. So it becomes certainly a national security issue. It's dangerous. America is, let's just say, not seen as the strong horse. And I think that that's why we're seeing so many things in trouble around the world, so many people at risk. I think that Russia would not have invaded Ukraine if we had had a different president, which, of course, followed the debacle in Afghanistan. So Afghanistan was not a bug of this administration. It's a feature. And that is what we're dealing with to this day. And we will deal with it as long as Joe Biden is in the White House.
Mick?
Tammy, you know, you mentioned the issue about national security, and I think you saw the same clip that I saw from about a week ago where he just got our policy wrong on defending Taiwan against a potential Chinese invasion. He got our policy wrong, and the White House, as they so often have to do, went back to try to walk it back and cover for his mistakes. Here's my question to you. At what point do you think they just have to shut him up? They stop trotting him out for these public appearances. You saw what was happening in the FEMA building. That's an embarrassment. You saw what happened with Jackie Walorski. You're right. Those things, they look bad, but they don't hurt. When he starts getting foreign policy wrong in a big way, is it time for him to just be quiet and for them to take him off television?
Well, I think actually both situations hurt because it reinforces that he's not in charge. And so regardless of which it is, it creates a sense of chaos. Now, I think there may be some problems if you have an elected president being controlled by individuals who are not elected individuals. If they're having to, I don't think that you're allowed to forcibly keep someone out of the public eye, the elected president. But the problem is clearly, even when they have a script for him, he goes off that script, like regarding Representative Walorski. Is that he clearly is not, can't be trusted to follow any kind of structure or rules. So every time they do allow him to be in public, they put the country at risk. We don't know what he will say next time. And, you know, we also can't dismiss Joe Biden's responsibility in this. He knows what he's doing. He knows that he can't do it. He knows that he's unable to handle these environments. Certainly, the First Lady knows, Jill Biden knows, but they continue to allow it to happen. So, yes, obviously, like with the campaign, they kept him out of the public eye. But he's now the president. And I think that there are some responsibilities. And I think if, in fact, the president was disappeared, That would allow what will be the new Republican Congress to demand answers and to find out exactly what's happened. I think they can't afford that. But at the same time, they seem to not mind putting the United States and, as a result, our allies like Australia, New Zealand and everyone else around the world at, I think, considerable risk from nations like China, which have no one's best interest in mind.
Tammy Bruce, thank you so much for your time. I was only saying he was my favorite American because he's here on the set, because he's sitting here. I got to be polite. You're my favorite American, and you're my favorite New Yorker, which is even more important. Thank you so much for your time, and we'll see you again.